Hey, what's up, guys? If you're starting a small business, whether you're an accounting firm, bookkeeper, maybe you're a financial services company, construction company, transportation company, whether you're doing concrete, I don't care what it is. I just want to talk about some of the hard work that if you put into your business will pay dividends. And it's something that I'm realizing more and more your website should really encapsulate. And when you do some of this hard work, what you'll find is that when people come to your website, they'll understand who you are. It's much easier to close business more often. If you drive traffic to your website, you will get more conversions. People will be more likely to trust you. Besides that, if you do the things that I'm going to talk about here, you will have clarity about who you are as an operation, what you're setting out to do. And most of all, I think you'll have an approach not only of how you operate as staff, as yourself, and this is even if it's just yourself or if you've got a small team. If you do this stuff, what you're going to find is you will have a framework on how you position yourself in the market. You'll be able to attract better talent. You will know who you are and who you aren't, which makes decision making easy. So right off the bat, what I would encourage you to do is develop what I call your vision culture. Now, your vision culture is a combination of your values, your mission, your purpose, and then your strategies. Now, one way to look at this, it would be a pyramid. And at the base of the pyramid are your values, your purpose, your mission, right? And then on top of that, you have your strategies. Your strategies are how you do what you do. And then underneath that, your mission, purpose, and values are who you are. I think it's really valuable for people to sit down and try and develop a compelling mission. A mission is what you're setting out to do that's different than every competitor. How are you trying to make this world a little bit better? How are you trying to differentiate yourself? So for us, we want to help make the web the best employee of small business owners. That's what we're setting out to do that. But better yet, here's my real mission, is to help maximize the efforts of entrepreneurs. That's what we're setting out to do. We want to maximize every calorie, every dollar. That's what we do, our mission, right? Our church, my churches, they are empowered by Christ. They are empowered by God to reach others for Christ. They want to reach other people for Christ. That's really what they're about. You'll see all sorts of organizations have compelling, simple, very simple missions. I think a mission statement needs to be concise enough so you can just say, hey, we maximize the efforts of entrepreneurs or of small business owners. That's what we do. So your mission is what you're setting out to do. You're on a mission to do something. Your purpose is why you do what you do. And the reason why we do it is we want to impact their life for good, right? I believe that by maximizing an entrepreneur's efforts, we will be able to move the needle of their life. And by building more financial momentum, we can just impact their life. So why we do it is because we can make a difference in their life. Which sounds kind of corny, but it really is what motivates me. I know that if I can cause a business owner's website to kick out more leads, better leads, if our messaging and our workshops help people identify what their business is about, if I can get in there and my consulting can help transform who they are, if we can fill their sales funnel, if we can attract better people, I know that they're generally speaking, they're going to be in a better position to have good things happen in their life. I hope that when their business goes smoother, they can be better husbands and wives. I hope that when your business is going better, or your agency's going better, that you can be a better mom, that you can be better parents. And I know that you'll be able to contribute to society and provide more jobs. That motivates the crap out of me. I love watching my businesses that I help hire more and more people and pay off debt and invest for their future and give money to their churches and nonprofits and to be generous with what they have. That's what gets me going. I know I can benefit their life if I help them by maximizing their efforts. Now, the way we do that is through digital marketing. We do that through websites and digital marketing, right? So again, your mission is what you do. Your purpose is why you do it. It's what gets you up out of bed and why you're in this business. You should think about that and develop that. Why are you doing what you do? And don't have it be bullcrap. Don't do this so that somebody else thinks you have a cool mission. This is something I developed 6-7 years ago when I started my tax accountant firm, actually. I sat down and was like, who are we? Then underneath that, you have your values. Your values are who you are as an organization. Who are you? Who the people are? What are the outcomes in the lives of your employees that you want to see? And for us, mine are to be trustworthy, competent, enjoyable, and rigorous. And I could give you a giant statement, and I could go on and on and on about each one of those. You don't have to go on and on, but you should think about, imagine someday you might be big. Someday you might have 10, 15, 30 employees. What do you want them to exhibit and exude as they work? You should do that thinking, because what will happen is you will start living that way. What are you going to commit to live that way right now? And I'm telling you, when you spend some time around your mission, your purpose, and your values, I call those your vision culture, and it's incredibly helpful. Now, last thing here, you have your strategy. So once you develop your mission, purpose, and values, those don't change, right? Your mission, purpose, and values stay same before COVID and after COVID. They stay the same in low and high revenue, right? It's, they spend the time to craft that together and then don't change them, right? Then what you have are your strategies, how you do what you do, how do you go about your business? And for your strategies, I like what Jim Collins talks about, where he says, we want to find strategies that abide within the hedgehog principle, okay? And for the hedgehog principle, what it is it's three concentric circles. And you want to do or perform strategies or do business that fulfills or can actually drive your economic engine. That would be the first thing. Can you actually make money at it? The second thing is it's something you can be excellent at? Can you be great at this? And then the third thing would be, are you passionate about it? Do you care, right? So for me, I'm passionate about technology. I'm passionate about small businesses. Driving my economic engine, you're darn right that works. Can we be good at it? Boy, it's been up my alley this whole time. It's worked for my staff. And the answers are yes. So what we do is we put together websites and marketing. And the reason why we do that right now is because that's how I can help do our mission to help maximize their efforts. I know that when we do that, everything works. So again, what drives your economic engine? What can you be passionate about and what can you be great at? You want to line up whatever it is that you're going to do into whatever strategy to accomplish your mission should be done through that. I think you should sit down and write out what's your mission? What are you doing? What's your purpose? Why do you do it? What are your values? Who do you want to be? Keep them simple. They shouldn't be complete. To be complete, you need too many words. To be simple, they can be portable then, so you can recite them, like you can say them in the car while you're driving down the road. And then I would say, think through your strategies, right? And your strategies can be not just that you build websites, but you know, what kind of, do you do it for a retainer? Are you doing cheap websites? Are you doing $50,000 websites? Like, what is it that you're actually doing? What are the strategies you're going to commit to? And I think that'll be good. Good luck, folks. God bless. You know, I would just say, if you're looking for help in any of this for your business, we've got a cool little team. And we will work our butts off. So for us to be trustworthy means that we are going to seek your best interests above our own. Trustworthy, competent. We're good at what we do. We're continuous learners. We try and deliver top-tier results. We're not just trying to stomp out what makes us the most money. And I guarantee you what we're putting together is great. Rigorous when we're working with people. We really try to make sure that we're putting out the best strategies, the best work, and we're putting the best foot forward and never dialing it in. I hate coddled ideas. I don't let anybody I'm around just do something for the sake of doing it, right? Which means I also lean in and try and give you my best opinion. You know, it's my job to hopefully move the needle in the direction of your business and be a good consultant for you, which means that there's going to be things you want, and sometimes I think they're dumb. And I'm going to tell you when I disagree, and it's okay if we disagree. And sometimes, you know, you're the customer, so you win no matter what. But ultimately, we're going to give you the best advice. And then enjoyable. We want to be good to talk with and fun to do business with and people that are enjoyable no matter what. And what we've found is by doing that, we just want to be kind, loving people that see the best in others, assume the best, encourage others, and put a 10 on your head as we help you. So if you like that, give us a call. Good luck. We'll talk to you later.